In this video, I'm gonna tell you more about the Kipron GPS 500. Corals, and if you see the reflection in the Kipron, the right one, you see my head with my glasses on my helmet. Hey, we were cycling, not running. It was kind of cold, kind of dirty, but good clothing. So, yeah. As you can see, all the good stuff. So I didn't get cold, but my friends a little bit got cold. Also like the very big glass. But this is for the watches, also tested like the Garmin bike computer and also the Wahoo bike computer. So if you want to see that, please subscribe. And yeah, and if you do that, please hit the thumbs up button. But the Kipron, difference between the Garmin 945 LTE on the left and the Kipron GPS 500 on the right. You see the difference in distance, but not only here, because the Garmin tells us 100.67 kilometers. By the way, we are here in Holland. We measure everything in kilometers, and on the Kipron it's 100.16. So a big difference. What is correct? Perhaps you can still see it on the Garmin. Yeah. But yeah, it's rainy today. I think we had 4 times of rain. Yeah, it tells us 100 kilometers. So yeah, is it a big difference? No, I don't think so. What does the Wahoo? Can we go back to the Wahoo? Yes, this is the Wahoo. It is a little bit more specific. It tells us 100.7. So I think the Garmin is more accurate because this is a Wahoo. I know because I saw it on the here. On the other screen it was also 100.4 or something, so I think the Garmin is a little bit more accurate than the Kipron GPS 500, although it's powered by Corals. And if you know the Corals brand, let me be, yeah, how should you tell it, they are looking at Garmin quite good. But this is just, yeah, comparing it in distance. What I will be doing later, showing you also the heart rate differences between those two devices. If you want to see that, I will put the link below the video so you can see it in the blog on our website. And then I will go analyze everything about these two watches, because of course, yeah, if you are looking at the Kipron, by the way, the Kipron GPS 500 on the right is $120. The Garmin 945 LTE, this one is I think $500, so you can buy almost 5 Kiprons for the price of the Garmin. And if you want a comparable Garmin, you should buy the Garmin 15, which is smaller than this Garmin 945, which has way less functions. I think the Kipron is very nice because it has, yeah, not the same functions as the 945, but it has really a lot of function, really in-depth running functions. You can connect it with Strava. You have, of course, GPS in the product, heart rate measurement, VO2, and all kind of running, not running dynamics, because that's a term Garmin uses, but it looks like running dynamics. If you look at the watch just outside, and that's nice, because now the sun is shining, so that's really nice. I think the Kipron, they look really the same, of course, quite traditional looking watches, but I think the Garmin looks a little bit more high-end, and that's not strange for the price difference. The band, the strap around my wrist feels really nice, both on the Garmin and on the Kipron. Also old-fashioned connections, but you get the Garmin logo on the small strap here. And that's not the case on the Kipron / Corals. I keep telling just Kipron / Corals because, yeah, of course it's a Corals product, and the Kipron just, yeah, they work together. But in the basic is it of course a Corals product. So I changed to the inside and still in the sunlight, but here I can show you both watches and looking now through the camera lens. So hopefully you can see that well. I will be a little bit slower because I'm looking through the camera lens to the both watches and to the functions. On the Kipron you have 2 buttons on the right and 2 on the left. It doesn't have touchscreen,
The Garmin 95 also doesn't have touchscreen, but like if you buy the Garmin Venue 2 or the 2 Plus or the 2S, you have touchscreen. So that's better on also on Samsung and the Apple Watch. If you have like more smartwatch, you have touchscreen. I don't really like touchscreen on watches because if I go running or cycling, it's just, yeah, it's not. You can just change the screens by if it gets wet or something, so that's not really nice. So if you can change some buttons, heart rate, I don't think it will go measuring it. No, but I'll show you later. We have the time of day, the hours. I was cycling for almost 4 hours. Oh, I didn't stop it, so it's still measuring the time. So this is the stop start button here with the small guy here, the running guy or a girl, of course. Yeah, it's, you see the way back arrow. Now up and down, sorry, down and up. You see the nice torque screw, so I really like that on this one. So you can take them off, I think, but I don't know if you can buy other colors. To be honest, you see the heart rate measuring, and here, so this is the charging place. And what's nice, it's not the same height as this one, so it won't corrode, it won't touch your body. So that was a problem with Garmin's for like years ago. And they learned from a course. So again, if you just please wait to start, it's measuring heart rate. So there we go. Can I show you the, no. Yeah, it's now measuring the heart rate because the small heart is like going bigger and smaller here. Now it's a nice test. How quick will it measure the heart rate? Not really great. So show you the other screens. And of course you can tweak this. You will need to install the app on your phone, like all products, like bike computers, smartwatches, running watches. If you don't use the app, you won't have as much functions. And of course, I really recommend that you use the app. Oh, now it's measuring my heart rate, still high. Because cycling in the cold, heart rate is still very high. And to be honest, I'm quite cold now because I'm sitting still after like hours in the cold and in the rain. It's quite cold. What's nice, you see the colors on top of the screen. So I'm now in zone 1. This is zone 2. The green, the orange is 3, 4, and then in red. But now we're really gonna stop this. Cycle tools, because I chose the cycle function. So let's just finish this, and then you can just like Polar, you don't do this, but you must hold it for 3 seconds just to be sure you really want to stop. Now you see the route, so that's really nice on the Kipron. The hours, the average pace, but it was measuring like long after I stopped, so average pace here isn't high, but if you just connect it with the app, it will be higher, so it will recalculate that. So you see here average speed with a nice graph underneath. So maximum speed almost 40 kilometers an hour, so not miles but kilometers. You see that there at the top, and average pace, so really nice to see. Maximum heart rate 205, really high, because with the cold and with this point out of the watch, so it touches really the body, but when it's cold, it's really harder to measure. So it tells us, I think, a little bit too high of a heart rate. I will check on that later. And now we go down 1822 kilocalories. Yeah, you can just read with me. So here are just the laps, not really interesting, and I normally don't check those things, but just want to show you everything. So this is the back button, and let's go back. These are the sport profiles, so if you just are starting, so let's go back. This is just a normal watch, and if you look at the top side, if you use those buttons, You go down, you see every, it's also like an activity tracker here. You see very nicely the stats. And you already saw it, but here you see very clear, it's powered by Chorus and made with Kiprun. Yeah, you can change all those things, of course. But if you want to go like sporting, you push this button and then you can just look at all the sport profiles. And you get also in the system, because here we are in the system, the boring stuff. So you can connect all kind of things, because it has, as you can see, yeah, I don't think you can read it really good. You see the water resistant. Yeah, you can just see it. So, all the functions, but I don't think you want to see that all. If you just choose a profile, like going running, then you see here, so it's already measuring here. And then you say just start, so you can overrule when it's not measuring GPS and the time is already going, and then you can just go down. I will put my finger after it. Now, what I will do, I will make a heart rate video on the indoor trainer, so, and then comparing it with a Garmin. I also have like the Garmin 55245, also some Polar, so I will be checking on that in another video. So if you want to see that, please subscribe to the channel. So you see all the, yeah, what I then call the running stats, the really in-depth running functions on a 120 bucks costing watch. That's really good. You don't see it on Garmin, Polar, Suunto, Fitbit or other brands. So the price quality is really good, I think, of the Kiprun. You see also the heart rate has now gone down 65, so that's really nice. Yeah, and that's it. So if you just push this and then again finish. Oh, sorry. Yeah, you see this, but let's just finish. You can just scroll and keep scrolling, and then again hold it. Save the date. No, just wanna just go back, and then you see like all the things. You can set up training plans and again connect it with the phone, but that's it. So the video is getting quite long, so just wanna stop this. Perhaps like thickness of the both products, which is nice to see. You see both the heart rate things measuring on the Garmin and also on the Kiprun sticking into your hand. You see that the Kiprun is quite a big watch, so if you have really small wrists, that's perhaps a little bit more difficult. Oh no, it's as big as a 945, see that? Yeah, so that's the same. But if you buy like a small Fitbit or the Garmin 55, it's really smaller than the Kiprun. So that's one thing to keep in mind. Material use, I think the Kiprun looks a little bit more plasticky than Garmin products, but if you buy a cheaper Garmin, it also looks more plasticky than this 945, so that's not really good comparison. This was just for checking distance, etc. So thank you for watching, please subscribe, and thank you again for hitting the thumbs up button. Goodbye and see you next video.